Hello, I'm Scott Holden. I'm the Director of Keyboard Studies here at Brigham Young University, and I want to welcome you to this hour of Highway 89. This is going to be an all-Hungarian and all-piano excursion this time, and it's going to feature Hungarian Rhapsodies by Franz Liszt. Our performers will be some of our excellent students here at BYU, and we have Daniel Messina, Michelle Pappenfuss, John Shumway, and Kathleen Finlinson. Now, these are, as I'd mentioned, these are four students from the BYU School of Music. Not one of them is Hungarian, but I promise you'll be rhapsodizing about them after you hear them play. This is Highway 89, Utah's most scenic musical byway, with a new destination every week. And thanks for joining us. Now, you might be hearing a lot of Liszt in the year 2011, because this is the bicentennial of Liszt's birthday. And for pianists, Liszt is a central part of our life. It's said you couldn't do geometry without Euclid, and I think there's no such thing as modern piano playing without the music of Franz Liszt and everything that represents. This project came about because one of our faculty members, Dr. Jeffrey Shumway, decided it would be fun in celebration of this year to perform all 19 Hungarian Rhapsodies. This is not a feat he would have done himself. He would have died in the process, I think. But he had designated a student, entirely in his studio, to perform one of these great virtuoso show pieces. These Hungarian Rhapsodies are one of the first musical forays into nationalism, and you've got a composer rhapsodizing about the music of their own country, and as for a change, they were not writing dramatic music, but music that was to sound Hungarian, based on Hungarian folk themes. Especially, a lot of these tunes are things that you might have heard in a restaurant or something, as performed by gypsy musicians. And they're dressed up to the hilt, as only Liszt could have done that. Let's start with the sixth Hungarian Rhapsody by Daniel Messina, and we'll go from there.